Today we were working on, this is a Carrier 58UVB 60060 from 2011. Over the years, we've had problems with these variable speed inducer motors. They get loud. So, what we're going to do today is they redesigned this motor. I have the new motor here. We're going to take that out and put a new motor in. Inducer motor. So it's not a real big process, but it does come with a new bracket for the pressure switches because the pressure switches sit really low. So I'll take you through the process of doing that today. So let me get started here. If I can adjust my tripod. Hold on a second. Okay, so mount the pressure switches onto a different bracket. Gotta remember, just taking a good whiff here. One thing you gotta remember is that cap. This cap does not come on the other inducer. Also, the standoffs. Standoffs don't come on the other inducer, so you gotta make sure to take those out. See what was going on, if anything. lining looks good. Okay, there's a new motor. There's an old motor. So we gotta remount our pressure switches onto this bracket. A bracket. Pressure switches go here. So, see, doesn't come with a cap. So, take the cap, slide it on there. Take our standoffs. Now, this secondary has got a, it's got like sealing foam in the, where it seals, mates up against this, so you don't need to caulk it. But I gotta adjust. Oh, I gotta change my cap over. Put the cap on there. Coupling on the other side here. Put my screws back in. Don't want to over torque them. So now I have to take and put my and I lost my 6-in-1. So you got to take the pressure switch off this bracket, put it on the other one. screws to screws. Let's see. Oh. Hooks up like yay. Is that where I want it? Yeah, because also, this is a two-stage Infinity, or no, take that back. This is just a two-stage modulating blower. With three-stage, I would have another pressure switch right there, so that's good right where it sits. Let me find the screw. Okay. I wish I had somewhere else to hang my light. Now, this pressure switch mounts right up there. Just taking some of the old parts off though. This does come with a harness. Goes from this plug. To this little nifty harness. So we have this here. Plugs in like so. And this plugs in. Let's plug this one in first. Your high power. There's your control power. And I have to zip tie that up, but here's my hose from my collector box. Here's my hose. Well, that's the hose from the burner box. This is the hose collector box. Okay. And the drain back on. clamp up and over. Let me get a better grip on it here. There we go. Zip tie this stuff together, tidy it up. There we go. Got it zip tied, tidied up. Got the new bracket on there. Busted it. That was a mistake. Shouldn't do that. Let that be a lesson. Screws there, sealed in the back. Stick my hand back there and feel the collector box. I'm just doing a double check. Just tighten that up, tighten that up, tighten that up. All four screws are tight, holding on. I got my drain on. Everything's set there, zip tied. Let's start her up. This motor has a different noise. Sounds more of like a jet engine. Start up. Started up, first stage. Alright guys, that is it for this one. I'm just changing this inducer motor out. Going from the old style to the new style. And there is a noise difference, so make your customers aware. And that's going to be it for this one. Give me a thumbs up, and I will see you on the next one.